Hi, I'm Tom Hodgkinson. I'm editor of the Idler magazine. And today I'm going to tell you why it's important to be idle and give you some tips on how to be idle. Throw away the alarm clock and let yourself sleep later. You don't necessarily have to sleep all day or every day, but longer periods of lying in bed not only are good for your health because you're properly rested, but they're good for your mind and your spirit, because it's when you're lying in bed half awake, half asleep, that's when you start to have good ideas. You might be saying, well, okay, that's okay for him, he's a writer or whatever, or you know, he's some kind of poet. Well, I think anybody, whatever you're doing, you can benefit from more idleness in the day. My first tip is really just take an hour break at lunchtime. Because of the work ethic and because we're anxious and worried about what the boss thinks and we want other people to see us working hard, we do crazy things like we work all throughout lunch and we work late into the evening. Another tip, when you go for your walk at lunchtime, leave your phone in the office. So you're not tempted to do your Facebook, Twitter status update. As well as the hour in the middle of the day, you can take the time at the beginning and the end of the day. Can you walk to your work? Can you bicycle to your work? Can you get off the metro like 3 stops before your office? Can you, at the end of the day, leave work on time? Okay, that means you have to be efficient. It's only idiots who work late because they're inefficient and they wasted the day. Idlers, we need to be efficient, we need to concentrate, we need to work when we're working. At 6 o'clock or 5 o'clock or 7 o'clock, whatever, leave. We're busy getting money, and then we're busy spending it. We don't go to church on a Sunday, we go shopping and we spend money. So here we are in Leal, a veritable temple of consumption. Problem with consumption is that it can make us into actually quite passive people. Instead of actually making stuff ourselves, which is enjoyable, even if we make rubbish, instead of putting on our own entertainments and playing the piano and singing along around the piano, we pay to listen to other people. There's actually a real pleasure in making things for yourself and being creative. And one way of using our spare time, if we have any, profitably, if you like, is to make stuff. And you know, that could be baking bread. It could be gardening is a creative act. Cooking at home is a creative act. And these are all things that we like doing because we're actually making something. We're not just depending on other people. It's 6 o'clock. This is the time of day when I can close my laptop and free myself from the office. So it's a really beautiful, lovely time of day, which I love. And I can just sort of start wandering around and let my mind go free and just become a flaneur. Really important, I think, to make some space for just going for a walk without a purpose. Is it possible to give some tips on how to be a good wanderer? I think probably it's up to each individual person. The main point, the easy trick, is to make a sort of deliberate decision to slow down your pace of walking a little bit. Then you start to notice stuff and you start to enjoy the spectacle around you. This isn't an activity or lack of activity that's only open to the poets and artists. I mean, you don't have to be Picasso or Baudelaire to wander around the streets. Anybody can do it. My final words of advice, I guess, would be the exact opposite of President Macron.
Je ne céderai rien, ni aux fainéants, ni aux cyniques, ni aux extrêmes.
So I would say to you, be lazy, be cynical, and be extreme. Thank you.